Dear students, hope all of you are doing well. Today we are going to discuss the first chapter of NCERT 12th standard physics, that is electric charges and fields. First chapter, electric charges and fields. Now, what is the importance of this chapter? What is the importance of electric charge? If you want to know, first of all, we discussed last year in gravitation. Suppose two masses are there, M1, M2. Suppose these two masses existed at a distance r, then these two masses will be attract each other with some force F. We already know that force F is equal to G into product of their mass M1 M2 by R square. This is the force created because of their masses. This is an attractive force. Similarly, other than mass, if you want some other more strong other than mass, means that is electric charge, or we can call it as electrical forces. This electrical force mainly create due to a charge of a body. It means, suppose I keep a body of charge q1 and another body of charge q2 separated by distance r, then there is a attractive or repulsive depending on the nature of the force, nature of the charges. So there is very strong force will be created rather than gravitational force. Such phenomena means this attraction force or repulsive force created between the two charged bodies is called as electrical force. This electrical force, electrical phenomena, everything is created because of the charge of a body. Charge of body. So let us discuss more about charge of the body. So what is the charge of a body? So what is charge of the body means? First of all, it is intrinsic property of, intrinsic means its internal property of fundamental particles or elementary particles. Fundamental particles are, what are the fundamental particles? We know, everyone is know, matter is made up of atoms. So this atoms can, every atom consists of nucleus. Around the nucleus, electrons will revolve. Inside the nucleus, protons and neutrons will be there, and electrons will be revolved around the nucleus. These proton, electron will have some charge. So apart from their mass, they also have some charge. Every electron will have minus 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs. So generally charge is measured, SI units is coulombs. So every electron, each electron will have negative charge, and that is a constant amount, that is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs. And whereas proton also will have equal amount of charge, proton also will have equal amount of charge, but polarity is opposite. So means proton will have plus 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs, means magnitude of the charge is same but polarity is opposite. Whereas neutron don't have any charge, it is just have only mass, does not have any charge. So more things if you discuss about the charge means, this is introduction class of the chapter. So more things means charge is a scalar quantity. What is a scalar physical quantity means? Body have magnitude and does not have any direction, means while you are adding you can go for algebraic sum of that. You don't want to consider its a direction. So a charge is a scalar physical quantity. And also we can find out and its dimensions. How we can find out its dimensions means, see, charge is not a fundamental quantity, so it is a derived quantity. We can obtain by using a current in a circuit. In your 10th standard you may be know that current in a conductor is equal to I is equal to Q by T, where simply if we convert Q is equals to I into T, then we can write I means current, it is in ampere, T means time. So a product of ampere and time, we can call, write it as for dimension of a electric charge, or we can write like this, or you can write like this, m power 0, l power 0, t power 1 and a power 1. So this is the dimensions of electric charge. And moreover, if you talk about electric charges, next thing is that we already discussed that there is a two kinds of charges. One is negative charge and another one is called positive charge. And we talk about the properties. First and foremost property is like charges will be repel and unlike charges will be attract each other. Like charges means like electron-electron or proton-proton will be repel each other with some force, and electron and proton will be attract each other. So like charges will be repel and unlike charges will be attract each other. This is the basic nature of the charges. And how we can convert, how we get naturally a charge is available in nature, means answer is no. Every matter, every body basically existed as electrically neutral. Why electrically neutral? Means every atom will contains equal number of electrons and equal number of protons. Then the net charge of the atom or the net charge of the matter is being electrically neutral. So how we can get the charged body? Means only by means of transferring electrons. See, only we can transfer electrons and we cannot transfer protons. Why? Because protons existed in nucleus, and inside the nucleus, if you removal of proton, we requires very high amount of energy. So we cannot move proton. Only we can move electrons from outer electrons or valence electrons. We can move from one body to another body. So while moving, every body, see, suppose there is a body, and if you remove electrons from the body, remove means before equal number of electrons and equal number of protons will be there inside the body. So out of that, some amount of electrons if you remove, then the inside that the quantity of electrons and protons, the ratio will be getting difference. So if we remove electrons, the amount of protons will be become high, and body remains positively charged. At the same time, if you supply electrons from another body to one body, then what happens means there is a excess of electrons, and because of that excess of electrons, the total amount of negative charge will be higher than the positive charge. Then the body, we can call it as, remains negative charge. Means if the body, if you remove electrons from the body or move electrons out, then the body remains positive charge and said to be positive charge, getting positive charge. And if the body gains, our body remove got some electrons from outside, then the total amount of charges excess, amount of charge will be negative, and this is body said to be a negative charge. Whole body will behave as a negative charged body. Now we will see some of the basic properties of electric charges. What are the basic properties of electric charge? Means first of all, regarding and according to our NCERT level, so we consider only three properties. First one is additive property. Additive property and quantization of electric charge and conservation property. These are the three properties we are considering. What is that additive property means? First of all, see, additive means total charge of the body. Total charge of the body existed as individual electrons or individual charge bodies. Suppose if your body contains Q1, Q2, Q3 like n number of charges, then the total charge of the body is the algebraic sum. The total charge of the body is algebraic sum of individual charges located inside the body. Means suppose if this is a body contains plus Q1 charge, minus Q2 charge, plus Q3 charge, like this different amount of different types of charges, whether it is a positive, negative, no issue. But the total charge of the body is the algebraic sum of individual charges. That means suppose, see, Q1, Q2, Q3, like Qn, a number of charges, then total amount of charge Q is equals to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 like up. So this is algebraic sum. You can consider sign polarity and everything, and algebraically you can add and the total. See, some example I can say. Suppose if Q1 is equals to plus 5 microcoulombs and Q2 is equal to minus 2 microcoulombs, Q3 is plus 4 microcoulombs, and Q4 minus 3 microcoulombs. That means there is a total 4 charges. Out of the 4 charges, 2 are positive and 2 are negative. So the total charge of the system, total charge of the system according to the additive property, Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3, like this sum of all the individual charges. So Q1 is 5 microcoulombs, Q2 is minus 2 microcoulombs, and Q3 is 4 microcoulombs, and Q4 is minus 3 microcoulombs. And if I add all this sum, plus 4 microcoulombs, this is the net charge of the system, or net charge of the body. Means this body may contain a different amount of charges. The body can be a conductor, a body can be insulator, whatever it is there, the body contains some individual charges, and because of all those individual charges, the body behave as some amount of net charge, either positive or negative. Whatever it is there, we can able to find out by using this property or formula. What is this property? It is called additivity of electric charge, or simply can call it as additivity property. Additivity, according to this property, the total sum of all algebraic sum of all the individual charge particles will be the net charge of the system. The system, whole system, if you want total charge, means you have to add algebraically individual charges, then you will get net charge as like this. Hope you understand. And I can go for second property. It is called as quantization of electric charges. What is second property? Quantization of electric charges. What is meaning of quantization? Means there is no continuation. There is no continuation. Only you will get discrete values of charges. Discrete values of charges means, suppose this is the body. Out of the some body, if you want some amount of charge Q, whether it is a positive charge or negative charge, whatever it is there, you don't get there is a continuous amount of charge. You will get only a discrete value. Discrete value means it is integral multiple of individual. N is a set of integers where n is equal to 0, plus or minus 1, means positive or negative 1, 2, 3, 4, like this. See, like by using this formula, Q is equal to Ne. Why Q is equal to Ne? According to this quantization of electric charge, total charge of the body always has integral multiple, always an integral multiple of basic charge, quantum of the charges. Means before property we see the net charge of the body is sum of the charges, individual charge, algebraic sum of individual charges. So this is again will give us some best formula. Q is equals to Ne. So by using this formula, easily we can able to calculate how many electrons required to form some amount of charge, or if you have some amount of charge, how many electrons are present, or how many electrons together able to possess this amount of charge. So these all things we come to know. So and this property we can call it as quantization of electric charge. What is quantization of electrical? Simply remember that means the total charge of a system is integral multiple. Integral multiple means the total number of charges, if you multiply total individual electrons, number of electrons, if you multiply, then you will get total charge of the system. Am I clear? And also third property. Third property, what is third property we discuss? See, first property is additivity property, and second property is quantization of quantization property, and third property is conservation of electric charge. Conservation of electric charge. See, we already, this word conservation means we already discussed from the last year onwards, work energy, power, wherever it is there. Conservation means the total charge of a system, the total charge of existed inside the universe is remains constant. We cannot create charge, and we cannot destroy the charge. Simply we can transfer some amount of charge from one body to another body. See, that is what we are telling, that the total charge of an isolated system remains constant. The total charge of an isolated system remains constant. Means charge, electric charge can neither create, can neither created nor destroy. They can only transfer from one body to another body. And this phenomena we can call it as conservation of electric charge. See, what are the three properties of electric charges we have discussed so far? Means, see, the first property is additivity. Additivity property means, based on the additivity, Q is sum of total sum of the charge is the sum of the algebraic sum of individual charges of the system. And second property is quantization of electric charges. Quantization of electric charges means the total system charge may be integral multiple of individual charges. So whereas n is a set of integers, so n is equals to q is equal to n e, where n is the number from starting from 0 1 2 3, like this. And after that, third property, conservation of electric charge means the total charge of an isolated system remains constant, and we cannot create charge and we cannot destroy charge. We can transfer charge from one body to another body. That is called conservation of charge. These three are the basic properties we can able to discuss regarding electric charge. Whatever charge it is, a positive charge or negative charge, whatever it is, these three are the basic properties of electric charges. Now let us see some of the examples regarding this charge, and we'll give you some clarity. See, the first example, what is the first example here? How many electric charges required to form 1 coulomb of charge? Means, what is net charge here? Net charge you required, Q is equals to 1 coulomb. See, 1 coulomb directly will available, can form? No. Why? Because Q is equal to Ne. This is the formula. In this, Q is the net charge, that is equal to 1 coulomb has to form. To form 1 coulomb of charge, how many electrons together can form 1 coulomb of charge? That is the question. So how we can write? We know charge of 1 electron. Charge of 1 electron is how much? E is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs. This is the charge of 1 electron. So how much charge I want? This much charge. How much charge I want? Q is equal to 1 coulomb. 1 coulomb of charge. That is the question. How many electric charges required to form 1 coulomb of charge? So the basic formula required is Q is equal to Ne. This is a formula we get from the quantization concept. That means quantization property of electric charge. Q is equals to Ne, where N is, we want to calculate how many charges. So how many charges means what they are asking, N value, how much, or what is the N value. So you are going to calculate, change the formula for N. N is equals to Q by E. What is Q? Net charge. How much net charge? 1 coulomb. What is E? Charge of 1 electron. That is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs. So if you do mathematical process, the answer is 6.25 into 10 to the power 8 electrons. See, this is a number, there is no units. Only number you want, the 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons together will possess 1 coulomb of charge. This is a basic example you can understand about charge. Means, if the body have some charge, 1 coulomb, how we can get 1 coulomb of charge means, here there is 6.25 into 10 to the power 18 electrons will be existed inside the body. So students, we see next example 2. This is a NCERT example. So let us find out this. If your body gives out 10 power 19 electrons, see, the body come giving 10 power 19 electrons every second. Means, in 1 second, the body emitting 10 power 9 electrons. So what is the question means? How much time is required to get a total charge of 1 coulomb? See, same problem like this, discuss as previous problem, 1 coulomb. How much 1 coulomb means? 6.25 into 10 to the power 18 electrons. Already we discussed previous concept here. See, 1 coulomb of charge, 1 coulomb of charge will contains 6.25 into 10 to the power 18 electrons. Now you see here, this question, the body is giving 10 power 9 electrons every second. So how much time it will take? 1 second 10 power 19 electrons is giving. So to total 1 coulomb of charge, if you want to form, how much time it will take? That is the question, and this is your NCERT textual question also. You will find this question in your NCERT textbook. Now you see, let us solve this question. See, what is the thing that information they are given? Number of electrons given out by the body in 1 second is 10 power 9. So then total charge, how much we required? 1 coulomb. So 1 second, this is same formula, will be same like Q is equal to Ne, like previous formula. Here Q is how much, means it will be 1 coulomb. N is what? Number of electrons. What is number of electrons we are given in the question? N is equal to 10 power 9 electrons in 1 second. That means in 1 second, how much charge will be formed? How much charge means Q is equals to Ne, N value 10 power 9 and E, charge of 1 electron, 1.6 into 10 to the power 19. So if I multiply, 1.6 means 10 power 19 minus, if you go there, 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 10 coulombs will be formed per second. Per second means in 1 second, this much amount of charge can be formed by using the given information. But what they are asking here, to form 1 coulomb of charge, how much time taken? Just you want to calculate the time. In 1 second, this much amount of charge will be created, and you want to calculate total time to take. This value means simply divided by 1, 1 is equal to 1 by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 10, then you will get the same answer, like 6.25 into 10 to the power of 9 seconds. This is the total time required to form 1 coulomb of charge. Am I clear? So suppose if you want to convert this into seconds, this many seconds you want to years, you can convert into years also. 6.25 into 10 to the power of 19 and divided by 36 year, I want to be in terms of years. So it can be 365 into 24 into 3000, means 365 days, 24 hours, and each hour will be 3600 seconds. So if I simplify, I got 198.18 years. This is the time required. See, every second, if a body emits 10 power 9 electrons, every second body emits 10 power 9 electrons, then total it will be 1 second, this much 1.6 into 10 power 10 coulombs of charge create, and to form 1 coulomb of charge, it approximately takes 6.25 into 10 to the power of 9 seconds. That means approximately 198.18 years it will take to form 1 coulomb of charge. But whatever it is there, according to given information, we did that answer. This is NCERT example sum. And along with these sums, two more sums I would like to give you for your homework. You can solve it and post the answer in our group. So what is the two homework problems means? You see, note down, how many positive and negative charges present in a cup of water. Means I have a cup of water here, a cup of water is there. So this cup of water contains some of positive and negative charges. It contains some matter. So how much positive and negative charges present in a cup of water? This is also NCERT question only, NCERT textual question, you can able to solve. But you have to take the information in as take volume of the water inside the cup as 250 ml, volume of the water inside the cup as 250 ml, and the answer for this question will be N is equal to number of electrons or number of protons existed as 8.36 into 10 to the power 25. Our total charge will be formed as 1.33 into 10 to the power 7 coulombs. See how you can do this problem, hint I will tell. See, total cup of water 250 ml, so 10, take the density as 1000 kg per meter cube and multiply, that means 250 grams of water will come. So from the 250 grams you have to convert into number of molecules by using Avogadro formula, and from the number of molecules in the water, how many electrons will be present or how many protons will be present in one molecule of water. Every molecule contains 10 electrons and 10 protons inside the water molecule, as you know, H2O. So by using that information you try, otherwise I will give the solution in next video. But note down the answer, N value should come as 8.36 into 10 to the power 25 and total charge must be 1.33 into 10 to the power 7 coulombs. And you see, one more question also I would like to give you. determine the total charge on 75 kg of electrons. Means there is a sum of electrons are there. All electrons together weighing as 75 kg. You have to calculate these many electrons together possess how much amount of charge. So this is one more basic question to understand the phenomena about charge. Just still now I'm giving basic fundamental idea about charge. In upcoming classes, more number of problems, more number of concepts we're going to discuss. Now to solve this problem, what you want to take means you need mass of one electron. You can take mass of one electron as 9 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg. If you take mass and divide this, the total number of electrons n value will come. By using n value, you can calculate q and your answer will be minus y, because these all are electrons, minus 1.33 into 10 to the power 13 coulomb. That is the answer you should get. All of you students, please solve these two questions, and answers I will give you in next video. And keep on prepare. All the best. Thank you.